So let's take a look at the spring 2016 outlook.
And everybody's been asking me all day about this, Jay. I said, you got to watch Jay tonight. So, you know, I feel like I should do a drum roll here because people have been waiting for hours for this. Days, weeks, months.
Well, you know, we're still in that classic El Nino weather pattern where we typically see a split in the main jet stream where the polar jet arcs off to the north into Canada and then back off towards the southeast, thereby keeping the coldest of the weather locked off to the north of us. We think during the early spring, this pattern will continue. Overall, we're going to have shots of cold air. Don't get me wrong. We have one out there now. We'll get another one tomorrow. But, you know, overall, it's going to be milder than average across a good chunk of southern Canada, the northern plains arcing back into the Ohio Valley. But here's key. Here's the key with the early spring forecast for severe weather. The subtropical jet is still going to be very active, we think, because of El Nino. The warm waters in the southeast Pacific Ocean will keep this southern stream rocking and rolling really for the first half of spring. That means we'll see plenty of storm systems passing through the southern stream basically off to the south of us. So we believe that the highest or greatest threat for numerous severe weather outbreaks. Can we get one here? Absolutely. But numerous severe weather outbreaks will be just south of us from the Tennessee Valley down through the deep south over into southern portions of Texas. Now, as we get into the latter half of spring, things will start to change somewhat. First off, the El Nino, as it continues to weaken, will also cause that southern jet stream to weaken some. The main jet stream will be off to the north, the polar jet. A lot of warm weather expected to shape up. Matter of fact, later this spring, things could turn quite warm across our region and points off to the north. Matter of fact, I've been looking at lots of information saying that the summer could be hot and dry. We're going to have to wait and see what happens there, but at least early indications are showing that that could happen. Nonetheless, as the southern stream weakens the latter half of the spring, that will actually cause the severe weather chances to creep off to the north. So it looks to me like our severe weather this coming spring is going to occur mainly in the second half of the spring season across not only the Ohio Valley, but out through the central and also the southern plains. So it could be a late arriving severe weather season this go around.
We've had a couple of times in the past where Louisville area, our whole WLKY viewing area did not, I can remember a couple of times where we did not get a single severe thunderstorm warning until the end of May, which is pretty extreme that late, but it has happened before.
Well, it was just a couple of years ago, wasn't it, that we went almost 8 months without having a severe thunderstorm warning in the Louisville area. I mean, I don't remember exactly when it was, but it's happened.